Hi, so in this video, we are going to learn about Form 5 Science KSSM. So this is a new syllabus that I managed to get. You can get this easily by Shopee online, buying it for like 9 ringgit, or you can get it for free by the link website that I put below this video, okay? I put this video, you can go to this link and you can download this textbook for free. So, and you save your 9 ringgit. Okay, so this is a new syllabus. We can see this is your new textbook. Let me see whether there's much different from last year and this year. Microorganism is the same. Nutrition, yes. Rate of reaction, I think it's something new. Rate of reaction. Carbon compound, I think they'll add some more thing inside. Electrochemistry, light and optic, force and pressure also is something like, I think it's new, huh? So this is the new textbook. Basically, from what I see, it's almost the same lah. It's not almost the same because I'm teaching science for so many years, so I think I cannot differentiate whether something is new or not. Sorry. So let's learn this. Again, let's look at this textbook. World of Microorganism. Again, we already learned from every class I like to teach about the word. Micro means small, organism means living thing. That's why we say microscope. Correct or not? Microscope. Micro, small, scope, see. See something small. Make sense or not? Microscope. Micro, someone got what? Microchip. I don't know. See the word microchip. Microchip. Means small chip. Microchip. Inside this telephone got a microchip. Microorganism. Small organism, living thing. Small living thing that you cannot see. Let's read this one. Microorganisms are minute organisms that cannot be seen with naked eye. Yeah. Microorganisms can only be seen with microscope. Okay, the micro and the scope. You know, scope? Scope is something for you to see. Like we see endoscope and whatever scope. Let's look at this one. Normal flora. Normal flora refer to the microorganisms that found in organisms, including human and animal, which do not cause illness. Observe normal flora found in the different parts in the human body. So this is a normal flora. Normal flora means it's a microorganism found in the organism, do not cause illness. Correct or not? Some microorganisms doesn't cause illness, and some is even good. So we got good bacteria and we got the bad bacteria. So we call it as normal flora. For example, we can see here is Lactobacillus and Streptococcus. Okay. So this is the type of the bacteria here. So we can see the upper part, this is the example. I doubt it will come out for exam, this word. But it's good to know. It's good to know. And I think maybe they will come out in objective. Like if they come out in subjective, then you need to memorize the spelling. But don't waste too much time in remembering the spelling, okay? So let us look with this one. Look at this one. The importance of normal flora for human health as follows. Normal flora compete with pathogen to obtain nutrient and prevent the formation of colonies of pathogen. So what is pathogen? Pathogen is a foreign substance from your body. Foreign substance means it's a bad guy. So, if I can say easier things, pathogen is bad guy. But you don't write bad guy lah, in the exam. pathogen is actually a foreign substance. Means it's not supposed to be in your body. Like foreigners, you are not Malaysia, you are foreigner, you are from US, you are from Indonesia. So pathogen is a foreign substance. And normal flora compete, bertanding, like fight. So this one, can I say, is the good. And compete means fight, VS, good versus bad. To fight for what? Fight to obtain nutrient, get the food, and prevent the formation of pathogen. If there's a formation, pathogen means it's a bad thing. You know, colonies? Colonies means it's a group of bad guys in your body. So it's not good, you will get sick, you go to hospital. Normal flora consists of bacteria that synthesize vitamin B12 and vitamin K. Okay, so it seems to be a good thing, right? Synthesize means, to put it easier word, like digest or eat, so it can synthesize your B12 and vitamin K. Normal flora stimulate growth in the body tissue, such as colon tissue and tissue in the digestive tract. So with this, we call it normal flora, or like the nutrigen or vitagen say, the good bacteria. But you don't say good bacteria. We already learned in the book, right? They want to call it normal flora. So you answer normal flora. Okay, you don't say good bacteria. You say good bacteria, then you don't get any mark. Normal flora is the good bacteria. Stimulate the growth of the body tissue, such as colon tissue, and means it helps to build the tissue. If you don't have, then your tissue will spoil. If you have, means you got more colon tissue. And help in the tissue in the digestive tract, means here lah, your food, when you eat things that time. Normal flora stimulate the production of antibody to fight against pathogen. Okay, so normal flora, it will stimulate the antibody, and then you want to fight against the pathogen. Your pathogen is the bad guy. We don't want the bad guy. We want to fight the bad guy. Classification of microorganism. Normally, microorganisms are classified into a 5 group. One is fungi, alga, protozoa, bacteria, and virus. Correct? Example of virus like virus COVID-19. Like we are seeing it now every day. There's COVID-19. Okay, so let's start with fungi. Before that, we want to know that what we are going to learn is the difference between fungi, alga, protozoa, bacteria, and virus. We want to know the category. Why we want to know the category? Just say everything together lah. Microorganism easy, no need to learn this chapter. Of course, we need to know the category so that we can study, we can learn. Right or not? If not, later you get sick and then you go to doctor, bacteria lah. Then you ask the doctor, what bacteria? Bacteria lah. Cannot say like that, right? We need to categorize it so that we can classify it, we can specify it properly. So microorganism divided to 5. Start with fungi. So let's read fungi. The size of fungi vary. Vary means can be different. Big, small, vary. They are microscopic fungi. Again, macro. Micro, we already learned. Micro means what? Micro means small. Macro means big. Macroscopic fungi, such as mushroom. Correct or not? Mushroom is so big. You can see mushroom with your eye, which can be seen with the naked eye. Naked eye, not your eye very close. Naked eye means you see by your eye, okay? Not naked eye means you use microscope. Not the eye didn't wear the pants. Microscopic fungi are very small, such as yeast, you cannot see. Of 10, this one is nano, right? 10 nanometer or 100 nanometer means times 10 power of negative 9, if I'm not mistaken. Microscopic fungi can only be seen with the help of microscope. Fungi like mucor, normally exist in colony. So this mushroom, I can see the mushroom. I cannot see yeast. But of course, you go to Speedman, you can buy the yeast lah. Okay, the yeast is the powder. Okay, do the to make the what we call it the bread. But still, you cannot see it. So you need to use electron microscope. So microscope got a lot, a few. Okay, one microscope is the usually one is the laboratory microscope that you see. I don't think this one is electron microscope. I don't think your school have. Means you are seeing to the very, very small until like can see electron like that. So we have mucor. Okay. Wait, this one got two arrows. Let me see these two arrows means what. Oh, this two arrow is the characteristic of fungi. Then we have mucor. Okay, exist in colonies. What is colonies? Can we see the colonies? This is the colonies. Like one colony, two colony, three colony, four colony, five colony, six colonies. Something like that. The colonies exist in 一大堆, each colonies. Okay. So the shape, unicellular fungi such as these are small sphere. Sphere means round, round. Okay, round sphere. Unicellular again. Uni means what? Uni means one. Unicell, one cell. University. I think uni is more like united, is it? Uni, university. Unicell, someone got what? Unicorn. Oh yeah, unicorn. Why? Because only got one horn. If got two, then you don't call it a unicorn, right? If you got two, means it's deer, for example. But unicorn means one unicorn, one only, one horn. Two usually we call it bi, right? So unicellular yeast are unicellular, means only one cell. Of course, we are many cells, correct or not? We are considered as multi-cell, right? Because we got many, many cells. Hair cell, skin cell, not only I have skin cell, I got many, 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 many skin cells to make this handsome face. And multicellular cell. Multicellular cell. Multicellular cell. Multi means many. Cell, multicellular cell, says mucor and sporangium, and like me also. But you don't say human, The book say like this, then we just follow the book, okay? Sporangium. Yes, I think exam will come up. They can ask something like this, okay? Because I think this is quite common. Which is spherical and halfa, which is filamentous, okay? So we can see from here. So what is filamentous? Filamentous means very small, like a thin diameter, like a thread. Okay? Filamentous, like very thin. So again, we can see here, for example, this is a unicellular, which is only one cell, and multicellular, okay? Like this one, okay? Spore, sporangium, hapha, okay? And which is filamentous, like very thin. Thin like a spring. Correct? Again, you can see here, thin. Like this one, you can see thin. Like that. And here is like that. Hapha, okay? Thin thread. Like from the word filamentation, is from the word filament, right? Like a light bulb filament. Correct? Filament light bulb. If I want to draw a light bulb, something like this. Filament. Correct or not? Because here the screen you can see that it's very thin. Makes sense. Let's move on. Nutrition. Ew, what is this? Why are fungi cells unable to make their own food? Some fungi are saprophyte, which obtain nutrients from dead and decaying organisms. Some are parasite, which obtain nutrients from their host. Still remember, I think this one we learned from two science. Correct or not? From two, I think it's from two. Saprophyte and parasite. Saprophyte means like a mushroom. People die already, you go eat. So this relationship is called saprophyte. Parasite, you eat from their host, like cacing in your stomach. So you eat the food, the cacing eat your food. Okay? So the worm eat your food. So this is called parasite. Like you do in your project group, five people in the group. One person didn't do the work, only you four people do the work, but all of you get all the same mark. So four of you can scold him parasite, correct or not? Sometimes you hear you watch Netflix, you heard people scold, right? Parasite. So if you are project team and your friend didn't do his work, just tell him you are a parasite. Okay? So what is the importance of saprophyte in the nitrogen cycle, carbon cycle, and oxygen cycle? Okay, this question is more towards the I don't know whether exam will come out. I think it will come out if this is a K-part question. Because this one you need to think, what is the importance of saprophyte fungi in the nitrogen cycle, carbon cycle, and oxygen cycle? It's important when dead organism die. After they die, people start to eat, correct or not? The bacteria start to eat that part. And this will reduce the carbon cycle. It will like, how to say it will become like the soil back, correct or not? Like you, when you die, if the bacteria don't eat you, you forever stay at that. But if the bacteria start to eat you, you start to become like carbon. Correct or not? In the terms like, let's say the dinosaur. Can I use the dinosaur for example? Like the dinosaur die, become like carbon become petrol. The petrol you use also is like carbon, right? Then after that, the petrol, then it will produce carbon dioxide. And then we have oxygen cycle. Of course, you still use oxygen. Okay. So we can see this one like, what is this? Parasite fungus. Bad guy. In your leg, if you didn't wash your leg, then you got all these things. You need to go to the pharmacy to fix this problem. Hopefully you don't have this problem. I never have this problem. Because like the fungus your leg is very dirty, then you have the fungus start to grow in your leg. You can try that lah, but I think you all don't have, right? Because you always wash your feet. Make sure your feet is clean and dry. Habitat is related to the nutrition. Got food means you can live. No food means you don't live. Like this example, the food is the leg lah. He eat the leg skin and it start to grow. So the bacteria is eating your skin. Ew. Method of reproduction. For human, how we reproduce? Human, we only reproduce by one way, right? Sexual reproduction. You get a wife, you marry, and you have a sexual relationship, and you have a baby. Guy and guy cannot have baby, right? But I always hear my students say, guy and guy can have baby. Where can have baby? Some of my students always say, guy can have baby. Then I say, if guy can have baby, then where the baby want to go out? Because the woman got vagina, right? Then the baby can come out. Guy, where you want to make the baby come out? Asshole. Asshole, the baby come out from the asshole. So no, guy. Oh, anak angkat. Okay, so no. Guy and guy, no baby. Girl and girl also no baby. No baby. So, but this one is unicellular cell, means one cell. reproduce can be reproduced asexually. Means no need to do sex. No need do sex can give birth to baby. But be human, we cannot. You want to have baby, you must be in the sexual relationship. But this one no need because it's say by budding. Budding is like what? Nah, you see, this one is the mommy. Give baby. Budding. But this is called the budding. Then, wow, so many cell. So you got how many baby? You got one baby, two baby, three baby, four baby, five baby. From one single cell, you have five baby. Luckily, we don't like that, right? It's very gross. Multicellular. Multi means many. Correct or not? Multiplication. Multiply. Multivitamin. A lot of vitamin. Multicellular. Multicell means many cell. Like the question asked. Give some example. Mucor. Again, reproduced by asexually by spore. Means both are using asexual. Means asexual got a few. One is budding, for example, budding. Or another one is asexual by spore formation. What is spore formation? These are spore formation. Come out a lot. Then fly, go to a place, the wind blow. You follow what the wind blow you. Spore formation. Or, one more thing is this one. Can choose. Either you want asexual or sexual reproduction by conjugation. Means they can choose. Okay, for example, this one. Conjugation, sexual reproduction. Can see or not? Stick together already. So this is called sexual reproduction for plant. I mean like for plant also can, right? Plant can have self-pollination and cross-pollination. Remember, you take one rambutan tree, then it got a seed and you eat. This is called self-pollination. Or I take the rambutan tree and I take another rambutan tree. I mix it. Chan zong. Take the pollen, go to the flower and then just do like that. Then it will become fruit. And usually cross-pollination produce a better plant, stronger plant. Spore are microscopic. Micro means very small, scopic means very small, cannot see. Released by sporangium. This is the sporangium. Usually, I don't know lah, usually exam I don't think it will come out this one, but I just read this one. Very light spore are carried by wind to a favorable environment. The spore will germinate without fertilization. In the conjugation process, the meeting of haplogous gametes are produced and the fertilization of gametes produce new. Oh my god. What are you talking about? Oh my god, this is so long. Do I need to explain every word one by one? What? The fine light spore are carried by wind. Okay, so it's carried by wind. To a favorable environment means go to other place, a good place. The spore will germinate without fertilizer. Means the spore is the baby. Let me draw the baby. You can see the baby or not? The spore. The dot is the baby. The spore will germinate. Germinate means start to make a new plant. Start to become a new plant or new being. In the conjugation process, the meeting of hype occur. Gamete produce. This one is different thing. This one you don't mix with the top one. This one he is talking about. This one should be in the new paragraph. That's why English is important. Sometimes you need to put new paragraph so that you will mix it. In the conjugation process, the meeting of hype occur. Gamete produce, and the fertilization of gamete produce a new mucor. So this is talking about here. Fertilization means you get married. The plant can choose either you don't get married or you can get married. You choose lah, you like lah. For plant lah, for human cannot choose. So again, this is Elgar. So I think for this video, I'll be teaching until here, and I see you in the next video, okay? So that's it. Thank you.